JavaScript classes only support single class inheritance, so in this lesson, we will look at how you can use mixins for JavaScript and TypeScript to implement multiple class inheritance. So let's go. First up, let's look at a few class examples that we might want to use in multiple class inheritance. First up, we have this class Disposable with an isDisposed property and a method to toggle this property. Next, we have this class Activatable that has a property isActive and two methods to modify this property. Now, if you wanted to combine the features of Disposable and Activatable into a single class, we might be tempted to create a new class that tries to extend from both of these classes. However, you will quickly find out that only single class inheritance is supported, and if you try to use multiple classes, TypeScript will actually give you an error at compile time. Now, the solution to this problem is using class mixins. Fundamentally, it flips around the order of inheritance. So instead of example inheriting from activatable and disposable, we can turn activatable into a mixin class that takes the class as input and extends that with its activatable functionality. We can do the same process for the disposable, and then we can create this chain of taking a base class, adding in features for activatable, and then adding in features for disposable to create this combined multiple feature class. Now, in order for this to work, the activatable mixin and the disposable mixin need to take a class as an input. And when you think about it, a class is simply nothing more than something that can be called with new, with any number of arguments, and then returns an instance of the class. We can represent that with a very simple type if you do not care about the type of the arguments or the type of the return value. Now, a class mixin functions will take any base class that extends class and then extend the base class with its own features using single class inheritance. And that is the general pattern for creating a mixin function. So if we wanted to create the disposable mixin, we name the function as such, and then within the class body, we implement the features that the disposable needs to provide. And then we can use the same pattern for creating the activatable mixin. We simply name the function activatable mixin, and then within the class body, we implement the features that the activatable needs to provide. And then in terms of usage of these mixin class functions, we've already seen that. It is exactly what we wrote before, and all we need to do is to import these two mixins. And now we can start using this class example to create instances of the class. You will notice that the instances contains features both for disposable as well as the activatable. Now, when you think about classes in TypeScript, there are actually two features that they provide. First up is a constructor function, so you can new up instances of that class. And we can see that we can already do new example to create instances of the example class. The second feature that classes provide is a type annotation you can use to accept instances of the class. Now, if you were to create a function called takeExample that expects instances of example to be passed in, you will see that you will get an error because we've only created the variable example and not the type example. Now, we can take this const example variable and use it to infer the type of the instances that are created from this variable. We do that in two steps. First up, we use the type of operator on this example function to get the type of the function. Next, we use the built-in TypeScript conditional type, called instance type, to get the instances created from this function when it is invoked with new. Now, you don't need to understand conditional types or the infer keyword in order to use this built-in instance type. However, if you are interested, I will leave links to the lessons on conditional types and the infer keyword in the video description down below. And that's the general pattern for using these mixin class functions to create new classes with features mixed in. First up, we invoke them to create the class constructor, and then we use the typeof and the instance type to get the type of the instances constructed. And the constructed instances of the class will have all of the features of any of the mixins that are used in the chain. Now, it should be obvious, but just in case it isn't, any of the features that are provided in the base class that is passed into the mixin class functions will also become a part of the output class. For example, if the base class that is passed in has a property called member of type number, then you can see that it becomes a part of the output example class. And that's it. You now have a general pattern for creating mixin class functions, and then using these mixin class functions to create extended classes. Now, our pattern of using these mixin functions is actually fine if we just want to mix in a few classes. However, within the base class, you can see that we do not have the features of disposable or activatable available to us. We can get around that quite easily. Instead of assigning the disposable activatable base class chain into a variable, we can actually use this as a base class for another class. So we take this chain of base activatable disposable and use this chain as the base class of our example class. What this means is that all of the features of the base and the activatable and the disposable mixin will be available to us within the example class. And we can see that by adding a member and then adding a constructor, the first thing we need to do is call super. And once we're done with that, you can see that this dot has access to all the properties in the class hierarchy. And because we're using the class keyword to create this class, TypeScript will create both the type as well as the class constructor. So we can see that example can be used as a type annotation and as a value. And that's all for this lesson on mixins in TypeScript and JavaScript. Smash that like and subscribe for more content like this, and I will see you in the next one.